Hey everyone, it's the Vegan Foodie here. So listen, I'm back with another story time that you didn't ask for, but I'm gonna give it to you anyway, baby. Okay, so let's get right into it. I actually had recorded this story time before, but guess what? My video didn't have any audio. I was trying out some new lavalier mics on my Canon, and guess what? There was no sound. So I had to re-record it, but I'm happy that I got a chance to re-record it because there was a lot of things I left out in the first story time. So let's get into it. So this story time is about how Oshun came to me. Now, a lot of people are, you know, just becoming familiar with Oshun and the different goddesses, Yemiya, Oya, and the plethora of other Orishas. But Oshun wasn't something, Oshun wasn't a goddess that I was researching or that I heard about and that I wanted to dive in and find out more and realize that I was a daughter of Oshun. That wasn't how Oshun came to me. I didn't go to Oshun. Oshun came to me. Now, this is how Oshun came to me. So listen, so I was dating a Haitian, and this was in 2013, 14, 15, around that time. We were together for 3 years. And so I was dating a Haitian who was from Haiti by the way of Miami, New York. He lived a couple places, but he was Haitian to the bone, down to the voodoo, the hoodoo, and all of that kind of stuff. So he would go back to Haiti to do rituals. For those who don't know, people go to Haiti to do rituals, y'all. This day and age, yes, it is real. So anyway, so he went to Haiti to do a ritual. And granted, this was before I was honoring ancestors. I just knew that I had a close relationship with my grandparents now that they had deceased in the spirit world. Because I was a medium, I was familiar with spirits, you know, still being connected to me and all of that. So when he went to Haiti, he came back and he was like, there was a lady there that was, you know, in representation of watching over me and told my grandparents that you can sit down, right? And so that it was time for her and him to take over. I didn't really understand that, but, you know, I'm really into spirituality and learning about different things. So I was very intrigued. So anyway, fast forward, he kept talking about this lady, had no idea who the lady was, what it was about, right? But I knew that we were arguing. I knew that I was over him and I was ready to break up. We had been together probably about three to six months, and I was ready to break up and be over him. I was like, I'm over this guy. All he wants to do is argue. It was too much, y'all. But you know, for some reason, I was there with him for a brief time. So I went to bed one night, fed up, ready to break up with him. When we wake up, it's over. You can go your way, I'll go my way. And when I went to sleep, a woman appeared. Now, I was in my sleep, knocked out, and my eyes just opened like this, right? So the woman disappeared. My eyes opened, and there was this beautiful child. She was so beautiful. And she had gold, like, on her face, you know, like a gold mask, I would say. Just like gold hair on it, and she had this beautiful chocolate skin, and her face was like huge, because when I woke up, I felt like, you know, her face was the whole side of the bed. And so she said to me, she says, you can't leave him, you need to learn something. And I'm like, but I just knew that this was the lady that he was talking about. So I was like, okay, this is something I need to learn. Fast forward, he started doing, you know, different ritual baths for me. He actually introduced me to how to honor my ancestors. It was actually my grandmother's birthday. He said, you know, make her favorite breakfast. I made her favorite breakfast. I wound up getting a puppy. It was like a lot of things that he taught me in this relationship. So she was right. I had to learn something. But I still didn't know who this lady was and what was it I was supposed to learn. And so as time started to progress and I started to watch him, our relationship started to flourish, and I started to really, you know, get into honoring the ancestors, which I didn't know I was honoring the ancestors, but just, you know, presenting food to the dead, as we would say, burning candles. And I'm gonna show you the candle. This candle, this type of candle he burned for me, and the monetary results that came from it, the peace of mind that came from it. But I'm gonna show you the candle because this is very important. So hold on 1 second. So I'm back. So you see this candle, right? Now, for those who burn candles and know about candles, you know that you expect for when this candle burns, it's like wax all over the place, right? But he would light this candle and there would be no wax. There would be nothing. It would just basically disintegrate and disappear. And I was amazed because I'm like, where is the wax? What's going on? And every time we would light a candle, anything that we were praying for, we were asking for, it would come, and it would come immediately, right? So now I was even more intrigued because now I didn't realize, you know, I'm doing voodoo, hoodoo. I'm just, you know, just over here just doing magic and spells and stuff. And so there came a time in our relationship where we were homeless. We were on the brink of living on the streets homeless. Now, we had a place, but it was some BS. And I had a client at the time. My boyfriend at the time, he was in New York burying his mom because his mom had passed, which I had a dream about his mom getting married. And then I found out later in the Haitian tradition that meant that she was dying, right? So, and even the house that I seen in my dreams was the house that he was at when he FaceTimed me. But anyway, he was gone, and I had a client. She said, "Oh, baby, you need some candles, honey." So, you know, I went and got some candles, burned some candles, and it was burning black. I didn't understand this at the time, but it was burning black, honey. Very, very, very black. The moment that he got on the plane, it went clear. Now, granted, his sister didn't want him to come back to California with me. So that's why the candle was burning black, because she didn't want him involved with me, come to find out, right? Sorry, y'all, I had a sweat break. Ugh. I'm over here with my Ifea Reina headband, my mini Oshun crown collection, you know, and I don't have a fan on because I don't want to have too much of that in the background. I already got the gin going, so, you know, I'm doing this for y'all. So I'm sweating for y'all. As soon as it's over, I'm going to be in front of the fan getting some water and cooling off. But anyway, back to the story at hand. So my ex came, and when he came back, granted, I burnt the money candle. We were about to be homeless. He came back with a bunch of money, moved me into my place. So now I'm sold, because this is my first time burning candles and actually seeing the results and going from sugar, we're going from shit to sugar, right? So anyway, I kept going on, you know, we were in California and Vegas at the time. And if you don't know, California and Vegas have a bunch of Mexicans. And where there's a bunch of Mexicans, there's a bunch of botanicas. And botanicas is where you get your spiritual goods. So I was going in there and I was getting my candles and getting my work. And I was really starting to work this out. So finally, when I became independent in my spirituality, our relationship was no more. He did me dirty. I ain't gonna say what he did, but he did me dirty, and we had to break up, and we had to move away from each other, right? So I was super happy about that, because I was able to really not get away from him, because granted, I told you I wanted to break up with him when we first got together, okay? So anyway, you know, I moved back to Atlanta, and here I am now, really getting into my spirituality. Now I'm solo dolo, I'm doing things on my own, and guess what? I'm lighting candles. I'm doing all of these things, these different rituals, these different spells, these different honoring the ancestors. Still didn't know I was honoring the ancestors. Still didn't know that I was working with my Orisha. Still didn't know what I was doing, but I was doing it, and I seemed to be doing it well, and I loved it. And I started to teach my friends about it, you know, that were in the industry. I was giving them game about doing certain things. And then I had an event. Now, I got to give a shout out to this lady, because this lady right here was the one that changed the game. And a lot of y'all follow her on Instagram because she's, you know, I would say controversial. I don't want to say conspiracy theories, but she posts a lot of controversial things. But when I say this chick is the bomb when it comes to spirituality, I got to give a shout out to Isis. Isis, and her name on Instagram is I Am The Realest To Ever Do It. She has a Telegram. Baby girl basically changed the game when it came to my spirituality. She walked up to me, and there was a bracelet that was left at the studio because I was doing a photo, because I was a publicist, and the day before I had a photo shoot at the studio, and somebody had left some beautiful hand jewelry. So the photographer came to me and was like, "Is this yours?" And I was like, "I don't know, but I'll take it." And when I put it on, she walked up to me and said, "You're a daughter of Oshun." So I was like, "Yeah, like, no, I am." Now, I didn't know who Oshun was, but guess what? And what she was talking about. But a small voice inside of me and said, that's the lady, right? The lady that I saw, the lady that my ex talked about, the lady that was appearing in my life. And so I went home and I researched Oshun. And when I started to research Oshun, it was kind of like the veil from over my eyes. Like it lifted from over my eyes. You know, my life changed. I started to understand who I was, not only as a woman, but understand that I was a goddess and understand the attributes in myself. And, you know, I started to the more I started to research Oshun, the more I started to fall in love with myself. The more I started to fall in love with myself, the more I started to do things that were for myself. And now I'm going to, you know, the Botanica, and I'm getting candles for Oshun. And, you know, after I found out that, you know, I was a daughter of Oshun, I later created an altar. I started to give at my offer. I started to give offerings at my altar, and things just started to progress. The more I started to study Oshun, the more I learned about certain things. That's how I found out about Shango, was through the way of Oshun. When it came time, I moved back to Atlanta for, was it the third time? Because I wound up getting a deal for a client. They got signed to a label. This all come from me working with Oshun and just, you know, doing my spirit work. They got signed to a label and signed to do some different segments on Love and Hip Hop. It bombed, but guess what? I was able to go back to Atlanta and I really started to work with Oshun. With my candles, with my spirit work, I started to connect with others that were on the same vibration. I actually wound up taking my initiation into Ifa through, you know, discovery of Oshun and the discovery of Shango. Shango came to me. I went to the Botanica and I was broken. I needed money to move into my place. And the guy said, oh, you need Shango. And he said, when you get the candle, rub it on your body. He couldn't speak English, but he said, Shango Macho, Macho Shango, rub it up and down your body. And I did that and I got the money to move into my place probably like 48 hours later, you know. So I started to understand that working with the Orishas and honoring your ancestors, you know, not only was opening the doors for me that didn't seem available when I was a Christian. I'm going to just be honest. You know, when I was a Christian, I was praying, feeling like a sinner, but still praying. And all I was getting hit with, for lack of a better term, because I'm in Nigeria, wahala, right? Which means issues, problems. And so when I started to really work with Oshun, work with Shango, work with my Orishas and honor my ancestors, my life changed completely, y'all. I mean, absolutely completely. It even changed to the music I started to listen to. I started to honor myself a little bit more. I started to do certain things for myself more, cater to myself more. My whole aura changed. You know, all of you that have been following me since the very beginning, I was working with Oshun then, but now I'm working with Oshun for real now, and you see the difference. You know, I mean, I even got her tatted on my arm because that's how much I love her. You know, so the story of Oshun coming to my life is, you know, is always, you know, evolving, it's changing. But I just wanted to share with you because a lot of people, you know, they want to know how can I get this. All you need to do is be open, you know, and if it's in your cards, if it's in your destiny, if that's what you came here to earth to do, then guess what? These floodgates will be open. I was 25 years old, standing in my shower in Detroit and fed up and ready to make a change in my life. And I said, God, use me as your messenger. Whatever your will is, make it my way. And then I found out about holistic medicine. I found out about sovereignty. You know, I found out about veganism. Well, even though I knew about veganism, I really got into veganism. A lot of things happened. Actually, after I started to really honor Oshun, that's when I became a vegan. So a lot of things changed in my life. I actually even worked with Oshun to manifest my husband. It's a lot of things that, you know, I like to thank and attribute Oshun, working with Oshun, and, you know, just honoring Oshun. And not saying that, you know, a lot of people are opposed to, you know, worshiping the deity. It's not about worshiping the deity. It's about honoring that which is in me, which is in you, which is in the universe, you know. So as I honor Oshun, I honor myself, and I understand the greatness that is within me, because Oshun, like people know, you see, this is a mirror. This is Oshun looking. You can't really see it for real, because my tattoo artist didn't do color like I asked. But if you see me in person, you know, you'll be able to tell. I'm going to get this actually worked on, but it's actually Oshun in the mirror. So, you know, when you're working with Oshun, it's like you're seeing yourself in the mirror, and you're able to really see yourself. Not this flesh, oh, I'm cute. No, the goddess. To see who you really are, what you really about, and what you really here for. So listen, I'm not going to take up too much of y'all time. I just had to share with y'all about my story time. Make sure you subscribe. I'm not going to hold y'all up. I'm just wanted to give y'all a bit of story time about how Oshun came to me. Make sure y'all subscribe to my YouTube channel. Make sure y'all follow me on Instagram, on TikTok, on Snapchat, on Twitter. Everything is the vegan foodie. All you got to do is type me in. And make sure y'all cop these headbands. Ife Arena is now available, shipping worldwide. This is the Oshun collection. We got the Oshun. Let me show you. This is the Oshun Mega Crown. And this is the Oshun Mini Crown. So, if you're a daughter of Oshun and you want to wear your crown. And I like this because it kind of protects the third eye. You know, so if you want to be a part of the Goddess Capsule Collection, all you need to do is the link below. Shop with me. And tag me on Instagram, Goddess Daughter. And I will post you on my page. Anyway, I'm out of here. I got to cook for my husband because, you know, that's what wives do. We cook for our husbands. But I'm out of here, y'all. Peace.
Changing lives becomes easy when you're amongst others on the same vibration. Join the Vegan Vixen Tribe today and become a part of a life-changing experience. The tribe membership includes daily vegan recipes, daily motivation, weekly Zoom workouts, meditation and meetups, discounts to various holistic and spiritual services, 50% off all Vegan Vixen collection for life, monthly trivia with chance to win prizes from the Vegan Foodie. Every member will receive a digital personalized membership card. Membership cost $35.99. To join, DM me on IG at The Vegan Foodie or email theveganvixentribe@gmail.com. Come be a part of a private tribe of women just like you, looking for a change and willing to do the work to achieve it.